Hello everybody, I'll be continuing my recording of the second part of acid-base balance, where I'll be mainly dealing with the role of the kidneys in regulating the pH. So this is the third line of defense. Kidneys excrete urine, the pH of which is around 6, with a pH lower than that of the extracellular fluid, which is 7.4. This is called the acidification of the urine. The pH of the urine may vary from as low as 4.5 to as high as 9.8, depending upon the amount of acid excreted. The major kidney mechanisms for regulation of pH are the excretion of hydrogen ions, the reabsorption of bicarbonate, the excretion of titratable acid or the net acid excretion, and the excretion of ammonium ions. Now let's look at the first mechanism, that is the excretion of hydrogen ions. Now this occurs in the proximal convoluted tubule. So you can see here in the renal tubular cells, carbon dioxide reacts with water to form carbonic acid. This is acted upon by the enzyme carbonic acid anhydrase to form bicarbonate and hydrogen ions. The hydrogen ions are secreted into the tubular lumen and the bicarbonate goes into the plasma, and in exchange for sodium ions, which has been moved out of the tubular lumen and moves into the sodium. So there is a movement of sodium ions and there is a movement of also bicarbonate into the plasma. So what happens to the hydrogen ions? The hydrogen ions is excreted in the urine. There is net excretion of hydrogen ions and a net generation of bicarbonate in the plasma. That means the bicarbonate has been conserved in the plasma. So, and this serves to increase the alkali reserve. The second is the reabsorption of bicarbonate, again a mechanism to conserve base, which is bicarbonate. There is no net excretion of hydrogen ions. Now the cells of the proximal convoluted tubule has a sodium hydrogen exchanger. As sodium enters the cell, the hydrogen ions are secreted into the luminal fluid. So in the extreme right, you can see that the hydrogen ions are secreted into the luminal fluid. The hydrogen ions which are secreted in the cells is by the same mechanism. So you can look at the middle compartment. Water combines with carbon dioxide in the form, and in the presence of carbonic anhydrase, it forms carbonic acid. The carbonic acid breaks down to give bicarbonate and hydrogen ions. The bicarbonate is filtered by the glomerulus and combines with the tubular with the hydrogen ions which comes into the tubular lumen to form carbonic acid. This you can see in the last compartment. So the bicarbonate, which is filtered out by the glomerulus, combines with the hydrogen ions which has now entered the tubular lumen to form carbonic acid. This carbonic acid is split by carbonic acid anhydrase to form carbon dioxide and water. Carbon dioxide will diffuse into the cell. Again, it gets ionized to bicarbonate and hydrogen ions. And again, the hydrogen ions is getting secreted into the tubular lumen. This occurs in exchange for the sodium ions, which moves into the plasma. And simultaneously, there is also the movement of bicarbonate from the renal tubular cells into the blood. So the bicarbonate is reabsorbed into plasma along with the sodium ions. There is no net excretion of hydrogen ions, no loss of bicarbonate through the urine. So there is again a conservation of base, that is the conservation of bicarbonate. The third mechanism is the excretion of hydrogen ions as titratable acid. This mechanism operates when all the bicarbonate is reabsorbed and the luminal fluid is bicarbonate free. So again we can see the renal tubular cells constantly produces. So you look at the middle upper middle compartment, the renal tubular cells is constantly producing carbon dioxide. The carbon dioxide reacts with water. In the presence of carbonic anhydrase, it forms carbonic acid. The carbonic acid splits up into hydrogen ions and bicarbonate. The hydrogen ions will move into the lumen in exchange for sodium ions. So sodium ions will move out from the lumen and goes on to the plasma. Okay. The bicarbonate ions also move into the plasma. What happens to the hydrogen ions which has now gone into the tubular lumen? It combines with a non-bicarbonate buffer like sodium hydrogen phosphate to form sodium dihydrogen phosphate. So the hydrogen ion is excreted as H2PO4, that is dihydrogen phosphate. And this is how there is loss of hydrogen ions. There is a gain of bicarbonate. Okay, the whole process will depend upon the amount of phosphate which is filtered by the urine. So in this mechanism, the hydrogen ion is being excreted out as NaH2PO4 or H2PO4. Okay, whereas the bicarbonate is moving into the plasma and increases the alkali reserve in the plasma. What is titratable acidity? It is of urine. Refers to the number of milliliters of N/10 NaOH required to titrate 1 liter of urine to a pH of 7.4. So it's a measure of the net acid excretion by the kidney. The fourth mechanism is the excretion of ammonium ions. So this occurs in the distal renal tubule. So the elimination of hydrogen, so here we have the elimination of hydrogen ions and the conservation of sodium by the production of ammonium ions by the renal tubular epithelial cells. Now how is ammonia formed? Ammonia is produced by the hydrolysis. So look at the central compartment. Ammonia is produced by the hydrolysis of glutamine by the enzyme glutaminase. This ammonia diffuses into the tubular cells and there it combines with the hydrogen ions which has come into the tubular lumen to form ammonium ions. So here the hydrogen ion is trapped as ammonium ion and is excreted. What happens to the bicarbonate which is produced? As usual, by the combination of carbon dioxide and water, it forms carbonic acid. Carbonic acid is releasing the hydrogen ion which goes into the tubular lumen. The bicarbonate moves into the plasma. And so we have excretion of hydrogen ions as ammonium ions and the recovery of alkali as bicarbonate ion in the plasma, increasing the alkali reserve. Now, what are the disorders associated with acid-base balance? The two main disorders are acidosis, which is of two types, metabolic and respiratory, and alkalosis, which in turn is of two types, metabolic and respiratory. Acidosis means there will be accumulation of acids, base is lost, and alkalosis means that the base accumulates and the acids are lost. What is metabolic acidosis? A fall in pH due to a decrease in the bicarbonate. So when we think of metabolic, we are looking at the bicarbonate component, whether it is acidosis or alkalosis. In metabolic alkalosis, there will be a decrease in bicarbonate level. And this may be due to either increased production of acids, like in the case of diabetes mellitus, starvation, where there is excessive production of keto acids. And when these acids accumulate, they are buffered by utilizing the base component bicarbonate, and therefore there will be a fall in the bicarbonate levels, giving rise to a bicarbonate deficit. And this results in metabolic acidosis. The second reason may be a loss in bicarbonate in urine in renal tubular dysfunction and from the GI tract in severe diarrhea. What do you mean by the anion gap? This anion gap is a biochemical tool to assess acid-base problems, and it represents a difference between the major plasma cations and the major plasma anions. The major plasma cations are sodium and potassium, and the major plasma cations are sodium and potassium, and the anions are chloride and bicarbonate. So, if you take a level of sodium as 140 and the milliequivalents per liter, and the level of potassium as 5 milliequivalents per liter, the chloride level as 100 milliequivalents or millimoles per liter, and the bicarbonate levels as 25 milliequivalents or millimoles per liter, when we add up the cations, that is 140 plus 5 minus add up the anions, that is 105 plus 25, the difference is between the cations and the anions is 15. So this is the normal anion gap. In children between 9 months to 19 years, it's around 8 plus or minus 2 millimoles per liter. And in adults, it is between 12 plus 2 millimoles per liter. That is around 14 to 15 millimoles per liter. Metabolic acidosis, as I told you, there is a primary alkali deficit or reduction in bicarbonate with little or no change in carbonic acid. So the ratio of bicarbonate to carbonic acid, 20:1, becomes decreased and the pH is decreased. The primary compensatory mechanism is through the respiratory center, which is stimulated, and you have deep and rapid Kussmaul breathing. This increased ventilation will result in a reduction in carbonic acid due to and the loss of carbon dioxide. The ratio of bicarbonate to carbonic acid then gets restored towards 20:1. So bicarbonate is decreased. Carbonic acid also decreases because of increased ventilation and because of increased loss of carbon dioxide. As levels of both components are reduced, the ratio comes back to the same as 20:1. The second role is that of the kidneys, where there is increased excretion of hydrogen ions as ammonium ions, or the increased elimination of hydrogen ions as H2PO4. Metabolic alkalosis. Here there is primary alkali excess. That means there is an increase in bicarbonate. Again, we are looking in metabolic, we are looking at the bicarbonate component of the buffer. So there is an increase in the bicarbonate component. There is an increase in the ratio and there will be an increase in pH. The respiratory center gets inhibited by alkalosis. So there is reduced ventilation, increased carbon dioxide retention. This causes an increase in the carbonic acid levels and the ratio of bicarbonate to carbonic acid gets restored to 20:1 as the levels of both are increased. What is the role of the kidney? There will be increased excretion of alkali as bicarbonate and decreased formation of ammonia. That is, the trapping of hydrogen ions to form ammonia is decreased. Metabolic alkalosis is defined as a bicarbonate level greater than 26 milliequivalents per liter with a pH which is greater than 7.45. Either an excess of base or a loss of acid within the body can cause metabolic alkalosis. Excess base occurs from ingestion of antacids and excessive use of bicarbonate or use of lactate in dialysis. Loss of acid can occur secondary to protracted vomiting, hypochloremia, excessive administration of diuretics, or a high level of aldosterone. Respiratory acidosis. Primary carbonic acid excess. There is decreased elimination of carbon dioxide. The partial pressure of carbon dioxide levels gets elevated and the ratio of bicarbonate to carbonic acid gets decreased and the pH is decreased. Mechanism: is due to breathing air containing high levels of carbon dioxide or some pathological condition in which elimination of carbon dioxide through the lungs is retarded. Acute respiratory acidosis is seen in depression of the respiratory center. This can be due to overdose of sedatives like narcotics. It can be due to excessive anesthesia. It can be damage to the central nervous system, that is due to trauma or inflammation. Or second very important cause is the reduced alveolar respiratory function. And this reduced lung function could be due to several reasons. It could be due to pneumonia. It could be due to pulmonary fibrosis. It could be due to pulmonary edema, or there could be obstruction to the removal of carbon dioxide from the alveoli. So any pathology to the lungs can also result in acute respiratory acidosis. It could be also a chronic obstructive lung disease. The compensatory mechanism is primary renal. There will be an increase in the sodium and hydrogen exchange, more bicarbonate reabsorption and increased ammonia formation. The secondary is respiratory, but it will be only partial. The low pH and the high carbon dioxide will induce hyperventilation, but the carbon dioxide elimination is partial because the lungs cannot, the lung pathology will not be, will not permit the optimum function of the lungs and the elimination of carbon dioxide. So as you can see in this figure here, excrete acid and conserved bicarbonate is the primary compensatory mechanism. Respiratory alkalosis. Here we have a primary deficit of carbonic acid. The mechanism is increased carbon dioxide loss. The partial pressure of carbon dioxide is low. Compensation, less hydrogen-sodium exchange. Less of bicarbonate is reabsorbed and more bicarbonate gets excreted. Thereby, the ratio of bicarbonate to carbonic acid returns to normal, that is 20:1, as levels of both in the blood will decrease. The causes could be due to central nervous system disease, meningitis, encephalitis, could be due to salicylate poisoning, fever, could be due to hysteria. It could be due to people who are doing high altitude climbing or hepatic coma. So this completes the chapter on acid-base balance, including the disorders. And as you can see, the lungs help in controlling acid-base balance by blowing off or expelling the carbon dioxide or retaining it. The kidneys help regulate acid-base balance by excreting or retaining bicarbonate. Thank you.